John Carter made the two-hour flight from Gatwick to Pula and then carried on down the coast to visit the island of Kirk and the resort of Opatija.
Kvarner Bay is at the north end of Yugoslavia's coast, a great irregular horseshoe sweep of shoreline containing large places like Opatija and Rijeka and sheltering a cluster of small resorts. Their identities have a tendency to blur as you travel between them by car or boat. Volosko, Ika, Lovran, Medvedje, Plumin, Labin. The names are different, but the appearance and the appeal is very similar. They're old and small places that began life as fishing villages, saw their first trickle of visitors at the end of the 19th century, but have tried not to change too much as that trickle flowed fast. They've had the popular package tourism of today grafted on, but haven't been overwhelmed by it. There's not much in the way of beaches along this Kvarner Riviera, but the lack of sand doesn't seem to matter. In the light of events that happened in Yugoslavia since that visit, incidentally, it's worth pointing out that this part of Croatia is many hundreds of miles from the Albanian border and the troubled province of Kosovo. If the word Riviera makes you think of times past, then some of the buildings in Opatija will delight you. There's a distinct touch of the Austro-Hungarian Empire about some of the architecture, which is as it should be. The first of the hotels was built in 1844. The town today is a somewhat uneasy mixture of the old and new. There are tucked away bits that don't appear to have changed at all, but close by the functional style of today. You pay a small charge to use the Lido area at the water's edge, a large sunbathing deck provided to compensate for the lack of sand. But it costs nothing to stroll beside the sea, to linger at the many stalls selling jewellery and leisureware, or to spin out a coffee at a pavement table. The Yugoslav economy needs hard currency from tourists, which is why there are lots of duty-free shops in the resort. The prices are in Deutschmarks, but they'll take sterling.
How much is the first?
This is £11. Thank you. Can I have...
The need for foreign currency is one problem the Yugoslav economy faces, but there's another more dramatically obvious.
Thank you. When I came home after my last visit to Yugoslavia, I had some dinars left over. So I thought I'd bring them with me to spend on this trip. Here they are. Now, 2 years ago, this little lot was worth over £15. Today, around 50 pence, not even enough to pay for this cup of coffee. As inflation bites deeper, the Yugoslav government print new banknotes with more and more noughts, and it's easy to become a dinar millionaire. Now, though that inflation's bad news for the Yugoslavs, it's good news for us foreign visitors.
The Yugoslavs have now introduced a new dinar, 20 to the pound instead of 200,000. Inflation's around 15 or 16%. The Hotel Slavia faces the promenade at the north end of Opatija, a part of town much favoured by British visitors. Though only a B category, it's wonderfully ornate. Its reception area has more than a hint of Austro-Hungarian grandeur about it. If you're here on a package holiday, it's worth paying a supplement for a balcony and sea view. Meals are served in the Bellevue Hotel next door, though the Slavia does have a snack bar. Pavement cafes are a big feature of this town. They get very busy early in the evenings as people meet to talk over the day and make plans for tomorrow. That tomorrow could well see you taking a coach trip, an excursion across the neck of the Istrian Peninsula to the little town of Lipica and its horses. It's a very well-organized place. You leave your coach, assemble at the appropriate sign, and take a guided tour of the famous Lipica stables. You've heard of the Spanish riding school in Vienna. You may even know about the Spanish riding school in Spain. But Lipica is where those white horses come from. The Lipizzanos. Tremendous ballet dancing horses. Back on the coast, a brand new bridge links the island of Kirk to the mainland. The largest island in the Adriatic, it's one of three in Kvarner Bay. The others are named Rab and Kres. Lots of Yugoslav place names are more suited to a crossword puzzle than an atlas. Anyway, Kirk's got its own airport and some pleasant resorts, one of which is Malinska. A good spot to choose as your holiday base, or you could go a mile or two along the coast, stay at the complex of accommodation at Haludovo. Hotel rooms, villas, self-catering cottages and so on. Here again there's no beach, so you sunbathe and swim from the rocks. Also on Kirk are several thousand beds in private accommodation, some in older houses, others, like this, in purpose-built apartments. Such accommodation is offered by some tour companies, though what you actually get is decided on the spot rather than by the brochure. But you can be sure of a uniform standard of comfort, convenience and cleanliness. Back on the mainland, but further south along that horseshoe coast, is Crikvenica, with a history that goes back to the Romans, some smart new hotels, and a centre that's as lively as they come. It's a place that's jolly pleased with itself, and with good reason. Of all the Riviera's little resorts, I liked it best. I was impressed by the Castel Hotel, converted from a 15th century monastery, and by the beach. Yes, a real beach, possibly man-assisted, but certainly not man-made. There's a Lido as well, a municipal status symbol around these parts, but the beach was good enough for most visitors. Crikvenica reminded me of resorts I found much further south very many years ago. Right next door is Selce. I almost called it a suburb of Crikvenica, but Selce would be offended if I did, because it's got its own very distinct character. It likes to compare itself to Saint-Tropez, but you'd need to stretch the imagination a bit to justify that. It doesn't seem to be featured in any British holiday brochures, which is a pity because it's very lively and obviously popular with families. But, as I mentioned, you can very easily get there from Crikvenica. In line with its Saint-Tropez aspirations, it has several art galleries, including one which occupies a former mill. An olive press, I think they said. Back in Crikvenica, a whole street of restaurants competed for our open-air custom. Most have live music, all have great atmosphere.
Earlier on, I mentioned the favourable exchange rates that make Yugoslavia such great value for money. But it just struck me that the value of a holiday has got to be measured in more than just money. It's got to be measured in the amount of pleasure and enjoyment you get out of every day. And believe me, they get a lot of enjoyment out of every day here on the Kvarner Riviera.